Under the lights, something new in China. The helmets, the pads, the hits. It's football American style in a country that doesn't know much about it yet.
Compared to the other teams around the league, this one's relatively new. How are you guys competing?
For a new team, we are competing very well.
These are the Beijing Iron Brothers, one of 14 teams from across the country in the relatively new American Football League of China. They're gearing up for a game against the Shanghai Nighthawks.
As this league grows, I can only see the talent growing. I can only see football growing.
It's a bold claim in a country where football typically means feet only and a round ball. NFL games are tough to watch because of the time difference. Tuesday morning football just doesn't have the same ring. Plus, sports like ping pong and badminton have long reigned supreme. But there are those who believe there's a yearning here for something a bit more physical.
I personally love the game. And I love seeing it take off here in China.
Chris McLaurin founded the league in 2013. A former standout at the University of Michigan, he knows quality football, and he knows his league has a long way to go.
I'd say that we're at a D3, a college football level at this point. More practice is required, but it's developing fast and they're learning quick.
Three, four.
McLaurin says he's tapping into a sports renaissance in China, with more young people than ever trying new things. And a much bigger league wants in on the action. The NFL is slowly increasing its profile in the Middle Kingdom and its 1.4 billion potential fans, sponsoring flag football leagues and clinics like this one.
Two, three, right there. Better.
Yes, that's the recently retired Peyton Manning, one of the NFL's most well-known stars, giving tips on a three-step drop back to kids outside Beijing. He's part of the league's strategy to have its stars help promote the sport, a hugely successful tactic already employed here by the NBA. Basically, the NFL is looking for a Yao Ming-type success story.
You get somebody that's playing as a young person and where there's interest and his friends are playing it and they're into it and creating that type of interest. And who knows, maybe there will be a player in the NFL from China.
And maybe that player would come from the American Football League of China. It's just amateurs for now. The players even have to pony up for most of their own gear. But the plan is to start paying players in the next few years as sponsors line up and ticket sales rise.
To see it grow from 5 years ago, to where we're at today, where we can get 5,000 people out to a stadium to watch a game, that's a huge leap.
The Iron Brothers ended up losing a close one to the Nighthawks, but they say they'll be back and better next year, just like the league in which they play. Matt Rivers, CNN, Beijing.